Hello from Chem Help ASAP. This video describes the discovery of GB1211. This compound is a ligand for galectin-3 and is in development for the treatment of various abnormal fibrosis conditions. The video reports the discovery program of GB1211 as described in a Drug Annotations article in the Journal of Medicinal Chemistry by scientists at Galecto in Sweden, Denmark, and the UK. Some of the scientists have affiliation with Lund University in Sweden. The citation is at the bottom of the screen, and a link to the article can be found in the video description. This video is not a complete description of the article. I have selected the parts I consider to be the highlights that best summarize the project. I am also emphasizing the details that blend with the topics I teach in my medicinal chemistry and drug discovery classes. The drug program we are discussing targets galectin, which is a specific type of lectin. Lectins are proteins that bind carbohydrates, and galectins specifically bind to beta galactosides. There are three classifications of galectins. The prototype galectins have a single carbohydrate recognition domain, or CRD, and can form dimers. The chimera type also has a single CRD and can form oligomers. Finally, the tandem repeat type has multiple CRDs on each protein. Each classification has multiple members, except for the chimera type. The only galectin in the chimera type is galectin-3. So even though galectins are a family of proteins, galectin-3 is an outlier by being the only member of the chimera type. So achieving selectivity for galectin-3 over the other galectins may be more feasible than expected. Let's discuss galectin-3 specifically. Galectin-3 plays a key role in chronic inflammation in major organs, such as the lung, liver, and kidneys, as well as within tumors. Galectin-3 triggers the release of different factors and signal molecules that affect fibrotic responses. Galectin-3 can also influence angiogenesis and T-cell response. Galectin-3 is broadly expressed throughout the body, but it is overexpressed at sites of tissue damage and within tumors. The overall goal of this drug discovery campaign is therefore to 1. Design a galectin-3 inhibitor. 2. The inhibitor should be orally available. 3. The indication of the inhibitor will be broadly disorders involving fibrosis. That would include fibrosis in the liver, lungs, and even the heart, as well as certain types of cancer. Galecto has performed previous work in galectin-3 inhibitors. In the bottom right corner is GB0139. Interestingly, this compound has a C2 axis of symmetry. This molecule is a galectin-3 inhibitor. Note galectins bind beta-galactosides, and the sulfur is indeed beta with respect to both anomeric centers on the two rings. At the time of this video, GB0139 is in an active phase 2 study for idiopathic pulmonary fibrosis. GB0139 is administered via inhalation and has low oral bioavailability due to its high clearance and low membrane permeability. GB0139 was the starting point for the current project. So Galecto started with a compound with poor PK properties, yet good galectin-3 potency, with a KD value of 2.3 nanomolar. The challenge was to improve PK and ADME properties without undoing the favorable potency of GB0139. The project started with excellent information on the nature of galectin-3 engagement by GB0139, as the researchers had an X-ray structure of a co-crystal of the target ligand complex. The X-ray structure is entry 5E89 in the PDB. Let's take a closer look at the co-crystal. Here is a view of the co-crystal, and we can see our molecule. Here is our binding ligand is kind of tucked around the protein, galectin-3. Let's change our view and just highlight our ligand now. So here's our galactoside. And you can see, let's make this a little bigger. you can maybe see that we have a lot of interactions, a lot of lines going from our molecule to the backbone structure of galectin-3. So we have cation pi interactions and hydrogen bonding interactions from the oxygens in the sugar. And just about every part of this molecule is engaged in some kind of interaction, whether it's the aromatic ring on one side, the triazoles holding things in place, and we have interactions between the oxygens on the sugar. This triazole is engaging over here. That's a pi-pi stacking interaction. And then this aromatic ring with the fluoro is. So all the pieces are engaged and doing work towards helping the binding, that great KD value of 2.3 nanomolar. So it's going to be difficult to change the structure too much without losing some of those intermolecular forces and likely upsetting the favorable potency. To improve bioavailability, the medicinal chemists made numerous changes to GB0139 by capping the OH groups as methyl ethers or acetate esters. Additional modifications to this particular hydroxymethyl group were also explored. In all cases, if the changes did not overly impact potency, then membrane permeability remained unacceptably low. If they managed to improve permeability, then potency took a dramatic hit. The scientists looked at their in-house library of galectin inhibitors. Specifically, they looked at how polar surface area, PSA, sometimes called topological polar surface area, TPSA, correlated with membrane permeability across various galactosides. They found that a PSA of 140 square angstroms was a key value. Molecules with a PSA greater than 140 square angstroms have lower permeability. PSA less than 140 gives higher permeability. In general, digalactosides have PSA values above 140 square angstroms. GB0139 is a digalactoside, so the discovery team decided to focus on monogalactosides, specifically 1,3-disubstituted beta-galactopyranosides. The team made a small library of these beta-galactopyranosides. They are shown on the slide. They are 1,3-disubstituted. The group in the 1 position is beta. These were made from a collection of aromatic thiols. With the loss of the second ring from GB0139, target binding dropped from the single-digit nanomolar range to single-digit micromolar. Permeability, in this case measured in CaCO2 cells, was not uniformly improved, but compounds with lower PSA did have better, even markedly increased, permeability, as well as more favorable efflux ratios. The loss in binding hurts, but the gains in permeability are necessary if the compounds are to be orally available. Designing alpha-galactopyranosides, in contrast to the beta-galactosides, gave improvements to potency. The first compound on this slide has a potency of 380 nanomolar. The exact same compound from the previous slide with the beta configuration has a potency of 3.2 micromolar. So that is roughly a tenfold increase in galectin-3 binding. The compounds in this series have been disclosed in more detail in this ChemMedChem article from 2018. The last compound in this table, however, the pyridyl example, in which the Y group is a nitrogen atom instead of a CH, is new to this work in JMedChem. This last compound regains much of the lost on-target binding with a KD of 25 nanomolar, much improved permeability, and hopefully a manageable efflux ratio. Note that the compounds on this slide again confirm the apparent correlation between lower PSA and higher permeability. Ultimately, 11D, the pyridyl compound, was selected for further study because of its overall favorable properties. On the left is a table of in vitro ADME and in vivo PK properties. Importantly, bioavailability in the mouse was very favorable. 11D also has a good overall safety profile. No CYP inhibition, no hERG receptor binding, no serious concerns for common toxicity targets, and no genotoxicity. While not listed on this slide, 11D also showed good selectivity for galectin 3. Aside from galectin 4C, 11D showed approximately 100-fold or higher selectivity for galectin 3 relative to other galectins. The scientists did manage to get an X-ray structure of the co-crystal of human galectin 3 and 11D. The left half of 11D closely resembles the previous X-ray that we saw with GB0139, the non-orally available compound. So let's look at this co-crystal and focus on the pyridyl thioether group in the one position on the galactose ring. All right, this mess on the screen is the co-crystal of 11D, and I know it's very hard to see. I want to show one special interaction. So here's our molecule. There's the triazole, the aromatic ring, here's the sugar, and here is this key pyridyl ring. Now let's rotate this around a little bit to change the view, and you can see now poking off on the side. So here's our protein, our galectin 3. Here's the sulfur, six-membered ring, that blue atoms of nitrogen, and here's the bromine. And I will note that bromine is not the most common atom to see in drugs. And when you see it, it's often doing something kind of special. So this is the bromine, and it is not too far from this carbonyl oxygen. This is a glycine residue in the backbone of galectin. And that glycine, that glycine carbonyl oxygen is disposed towards the bromine in this pyridyl ring, and that is creating something that's called a halogen hole interaction. And a lone pair on that carbonyl is interacting with an antibonding orbital on that bromine. So it's not unique, but they're not commonly seen. So when you see bromines in drugs, less common atoms, sometimes they're doing something interesting to generate some kind of special binding. And that's an example of a halogen hole. So I wanted to highlight that from this co-crystal of galectin 3 and 11D. Up until this point in this video, we have seen evidence for target engagement, KD of different ligands on galectin 3, and X-ray structures, but we haven't seen any results from functional assays. On this slide are some functional assay results. The scientists looked at human liver fibroblasts and incubated them with TGF-beta, transforming growth factor beta, and various concentrations of 11D. TGF-beta and galectin 3 play key roles in the activation of fibrotic responses. So if 11D blocks galectin 3, fibrotic responses will be diminished. For this assay, the expression level of 4 genes were monitored. Each of these genes is linked to the expression of fibrotic proteins. For example, COL1A2 is a collagen protein. The IC50 of 11D across all 4 proteins was very similar and close to 60 nanomolar based on reading the response curves in the paper, specifically figure 5 if you're interested. This IC50 value is in good agreement with 11D's KD value for galectin 3 at 25 nanomolar. So this in vitro result is a favorable indication of efficacy for 11D. For in vivo activity, the Galecto researchers used 2 animal disease models, both in mice. The first looked at mice with induced liver fibrosis. 11D was tested at oral doses of 2 and 10 mg per kg twice daily over 4 weeks. At the conclusion of the study, mice in the high dose group had an approximately 35% reduction in liver collagen relative to the untreated animals in the vehicle group. The amount of collagen was measured through analysis of stained liver tissue under a microscope. The second animal disease model involved lung fibrosis. Animals with induced lung fibrosis were dosed twice per day with 2 and 20 mg per kg of 11D over 2 weeks. The study also included a group of healthy animals. At the end of the study, the high-dose group showed approximately a 50% collagen reduction relative to the increased collagen levels observed in the untreated diseased animals. The second study was more fully disclosed in the supplementary information, not the body of the paper itself. The favorable results in mice were especially encouraging, as mouse galectin-3 has some sequence differences from human galectin-3, and the affinity of 11D is much lower for mouse galectin-3. So presumably, reduction in fibrosis in humans could be even greater or achieved at a lower dosing level. Based on the promising efficacy, safety, and PK properties of 11D, the compound has been advanced into the clinic. So compound 11D, which has a drug candidate compound number of GB1211, is listed in the paper as being active in two clinical trials. One is phase 1 for liver fibrosis. The other is a phase 1-2 trial for non-small cell lung cancer, in combination with another therapy, an antibody. Before finalizing this video, I checked clinicaltrials.gov, and the liver fibrosis trial has not been updated for over a year and a half. The cancer trial has not been updated since early 2022, but may still be recruiting patients. Thank you so much for watching to the end of this drug discovery story on GB1211, an inhibitor of galectin-3. A link to the original JMedChem article is in the video description. Please consider subscribing to the channel, leaving a like, or making a comment. Take care.